I want to believe that when you are operating a system we call democracy, perhaps you allow everyone to go by his own thought. You don't stop anyone. But the fact remains that as representatives of the people of the Federal Republic of Nigeria, we have always have a course, we have a direction, and there are also guiding principles for us to operate as representatives of the people. And the House, for me, has gotten a seasoned legislator. Even the Senate, too. We have a seasoned senator who is now the presiding officer of the Senate, and also a seasoned legislator who is the presiding officer of the House of Representatives. And right from the word go, we now looked back. The Speaker, who has served severally, the Senate President, who has also served severally in different capacities of the House of Representatives and in the Senate as well. So we now decided and agreed by our legislative agenda that no, it cannot be business as usual. The fact that we are just legislature, we are not meant to come and be fighting with the executive arm of government. After all, it is one government that we must operate on the same page. You cannot just single-handedly call the executive as the government. The executive alone is not the government. The legislature as an institution is not also the government alone. It is the tripartite coexistence, peaceful coexistence, despite our different constitutional responsibilities, that forms a government. If for any reason, God forbid, the executive or the president or the vice president fails in one way or the other, it is by extension a failure of the legislative institution as well. So when we started, we now agreed and put in our legislative agenda that there must have to be a paradigm shift. Shift in terms of our legislative duties, shift in terms of the way and manner we relate to the executive arm of government, shift in the terms in terms of our proactiveness in responding to the yearnings and aspirations of Nigerians. For as long as we will continue to bear the name of, yes, we are the ambassadors of the Nigerian people on the Green Chamber and on the Senate, the Red Chamber, then certainly we must have to walk in mutual coexistence with the two other arms of government to deliver the deliverables and to also be able to provide good governance for the people of the Federal Republic of Nigeria. It does not matter what names you call us. If it means, oh, we have to find a situation whereby you always sustain the cat and mouse relationship that existed in the past, which had not been productive, did not produce anything that you can now beat your chest to say, oh, this is good governance. Except we have to maybe find a situation whereby our presiding officers who are elected on the platform of the ruling APC will have cause to now defect to the opposition party and run a legislature under an opposition party. Then I want to say, if those are the judgments of Nigerian people that we have to do that before we are called proactive, or we have to do that before we are seen to be doing our job, then I will now tell them, sorry. We are not out for that. We are out to deliver our legislative duties and responsibilities with a difference.